Can you visualize?
Okay. Yeah.
Therefore, the chord line at the fuselage is much bigger than the chord line at the wingtip.
Okay.
So the manufacturers calculate what is called a mean aerodynamic chord. Now in your notes, have a look at figure 2.10.
Hello, sir. Which page?
Page 48. Figure 2.10.
Okay, 2.10. Can we share?
There are two diagrams, one on top, one at the bottom. Yeah. The top one shows us a wing. Can you see when it is connected to the fuselage, it's very long, big, and at the wing tip, it tapers down. Yeah. This is very big and here it tapers down. So the manufacturer will calculate a mean aerodynamic chord that is fixed and they will give it to us. So
okay.
Now look at the CG. If the CG is in the center of the MAC, it is at 50% of MAC. Clear? CG position is 50% of MAC. Now if the CG moves forward, it will be less than 50%, correct?
Okay.
If the CG moves backwards, it will be more than 50% of the MAC. So calculation of the CG in percentage of MAC is useful. Later on, it will come in handy when you do your performance. Now, there are a few things that we must study. What is this? What does this indicate? These two lines.
Which one, sir?
This line and this line. These two vertical lines, what do they indicate?
The forward and aft limit.
Very correct. Forward and aft limit of CG. What is this? This is the datum, correct?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if the datum is here and the forward limit is behind the datum, what is the sign that we use?
Negative, sir.
Negative.
Hey, if it is behind the datum?
Positive.
Positive.
It's positive, sir. Sorry.
If it is in front of the datum, it will be negative. The arm negative. Will be negative. So now both the forward limit and aft limit are behind the datum, so they will be positive. Clear?
Okay.
Okay. Now go to the lower figure. No. The same 2.10.
Okay.
Yeah. The lower figure. Can you see the fuselage and the tail and the CG? Forward okay. limit, aft limit and the datum. Okay.
Okay.
Now there are three A, B and C. We have to mark this up. What is A? What is B? What is C? Because the formula it's depends upon
CG
that.
From datum.
What is A? A is the distance of CG from the datum. Very important. A is always the distance of CG from the datum. But tell me, can it be positive or negative?
Just if
positive.
If the datum is here, this will be, as it is shown, it is showing positive. Can you see that?
Yes.
Everything is yes. positive because everything is behind the datum. But the datum can change. Datum can be here, datum can be here, datum can be anywhere. Are you all understanding?
Yes, sir.
So we have to understand that A, which is distance of CG from datum, can be positive or negative. Has everybody understood that?
Okay.
That is the definition of A. What is B? What do you see for B?
Distance of MSC
leading. Distance of MSC leading edge. This is the mean aerodynamic chord. That is the CG position, forward and backward. That is called now a mean aerodynamic chord. Forward limit of mean aerodynamic chord and this thing, CG is always in between this. So what is B?
It's distance of MSC.
Distance of leading edge. From the datum. Can it be plus or minus?
is plus.
If
plus.
The datum is here, then?
Plus.
Plus.
Today it is plus. If the datum shifts somewhere here, what will happen?
Negative.
Yeah, you have to identify. When you see a figure, when you get a question, you must identify where is the datum and what is the plus or minus sign of A, B, and C is straightforward. It is the MAC. That is
fine. Sir. Sir, sorry, sir. Sir, so let's say if the datum like this one, let's say it is a shifted behind the leading edge, then then the leading edge become negative, right?
Yes, then the arm becomes minus.
Oh.
Very important. Okay, the sign is very important.
Okay.
So when you draw when you get a question, you got to draw the aircraft, you got to draw the datum, you got to draw this MAC, CG position forward, and then identify where is the datum. Is it plus or minus? We'll come to that. But here you have to understand datum and arm. What is the relationship? Arm behind the datum is plus. Arm in front of the datum is minus. Is it clear?
Sir, so for this case, for this figure, as we assume that the datum is okay, so because there's no items in front of the datum, so means there's no negative data.
Yes, very correct. Good analysis. Very good. Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
So we have a formula. Okay, now we have a formula to calculate CG as a percentage of MAC. Okay. It's very simple formula. A minus B upon C multiplied by 100. So on your papers, now, Abdul, move this figure up, page up, move it up. No, then down, move it down.
Okay, down.
We get the first question.
Okay,
example 4. Now, is given an example. What is this? If the MAC is 152 inches and its leading edge is 40 inches aft of datum and the CG is 60 inches aft of datum, what is the CG position as a percentage of MAC? Let's draw it out. Here is an aircraft that is drawn, nose and tail. Draw it out on your paper. You have to identify these vertical lines, datum, forward limit of MAC, aft limit of MAC. And then plot it as given. MAC is 152. To write down, C is equal to 152. What is A?
A is
66. CG from data.
CG is 66.
Plus 66. What is B?
B is 40.
40.
40 plus 40. What do you have to find out?
40.
You have to find out. Yeah, you have to find out percentage.
Plus 40. Right,
percentage of MAC, CG position of MAC is equal to A minus B upon
C
multiplied by 100. So you have A, B, C given. You can find out your MAC percentage. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So if anything is missing, A can be missing, B can be missing, C will not be missing. Your percentage can be missing. You can find out by this formula. What is the formula? Percentage of MAC is equal to
A minus B.
A minus B upon C multiplied by 100.
100.
Has everybody understood this example 4?
So for this, for this diagram, the fixed variable is the C, right? Because MAC shouldn't
be changed. Yes, correct. MAC is fixed. That is what you got to draw. Then you got to place your datum and find out what is A, B. Is it plus, minus, etc. So if one of them is missing, you can find out the other one. For example, let us try now these couple of questions. Question number one. Everyone draw an aircraft, nose and tail, and put your MSE 82 inches. Now it says the leading edge of MSE is 103 inches aft of datum. Where will the datum be?
Leading edge.
Where will the datum be?
Behind.
Now just let's figure out. So what is C?
82.
What is B?
B is
negative 103.
No, not negative. The datum is in front. It says aft of the datum.
Aft of datum, 103.
The leading edge of MSC is aft of datum.
So
what will the sign be?
Plus.
Yes. Now he has given us the CG position. So in the formula, 14.7 is equal to A minus B upon C. So what is A? We got to find out. So A minus B upon C into 100. Write down 14.7 equals A minus B upon C into 100.
115, sir.
So 14.7 divided by 100 is equal to A minus B upon C.
How much is
14.7 divided by 100?
Yeah.
Okay. Now 0.147 multiplied by 82 is equal to A minus B. So how much is 82 multiplied by 0.147? Go step by step.
12.054
equals, yeah, correct. Equals what? A minus B. How much is B?
103.
So what do you do to find out A? You bring 103 on the left side.
Plus 103.
Very correct. How much is the answer?
115.054.
So that is A. So your answer is the CG position is 115.054 inches aft of datum. Are you getting it?
Yes.
Yes.
Wonderful. Yes. Has everybody got it? Anybody, any question? If no, then there is a correction to be made in question number 2. Question number 2 states the CG position is 21% MSC and the MSC is 23 inches and datum. Cancel that CG.
CG datum.
Not CG, just cancel the datum. CG. What is the, and the datum is how much?
26 inch.
Now come on, draw this figure. Everybody draw it. Draw a straight line, put the nose, put the tail. What is your MSC?
73 inches. C,
that is C is equal to 73 inches. Write on A, B, C. What is A? What is B? What is C? Come on.
And the CG is 26. So A is 26 inch.
Yeah,
Oh, so we don't know B. Okay.
Look at that, 26 inches aft of leading edge of MAC. B. So draw the datum correctly, please. Think. MAC is 73 inches and datum is 23 inches aft of leading edge of MAC.
Itu datum, Zim.
Yeah. Datum, CG datum.
So what is A?
Oh, okay.
What is B? And what is C? Come on.
B is 26 inch.
26 what? Plus or minus?
Minus.
Be careful.
Minus.
So right now the B is minus 26. Okay. So what is A?
A, we didn't get yet.
We didn't get. What is CG percentage?
CG percentage 21%.
So you write down 21% equals A minus B. That is minus minus. We have to be careful. Put minus B bracket. Put minus 26. Divide by C into 100. What is C?
73.
So
21 equals A minus, in bracket, minus 26. Divide by C, that is 73. Multiply by 100. So 21 divided by 100 is equal to A minus B upon C. How much is 21 divided by 100?
0.21
multiplied by 73 is equal to A plus 26. When you open bracket, minus minus becomes plus. So now what is A? Can you tell me? What is the answer?
Minus 10.67.
Very correct. You must get your signs correctly. So A will be minus 10.67. So this is how you work out by drawing the figure. Draw your aircraft, read the question carefully, understand it, draw your datum. Draw your datum and then identify A minus B minus C. Now let me see you using your head for the next one. Think carefully. Is everybody with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Good. Yes. Be very careful when you draw the figure. You have to be careful when you draw the datum. The CG limit is 5 inches forward and 7 inches aft of datum. Be careful how you draw the datum.
So,
what is the MAC?
41.
So draw your MAC 41. Where will the datum be?
It may be middle.
Behind.
Behind leading edge.
In the middle of MAC, correct? Because the CG limit is forward and backward, two limits.
So
the leading edge is how much? Plus or minus?
Minus.
So what is that? That is A, B or C. What is it?
B.
B. So write on B is equal to minus 15. A, we got to find out forward limit and aft limit. What is here? A is what in the first instance?
Negative 5.
What is the value of A?
Negative 5.
And?
Positive
7.
Yes, negative 5 and positive 7. B is constant minus negative 15. What is C?
41.
So you get two answers. One is the forward limit, the other is the aft limit. So I'll work out your formula. Percentage of CGMAC is equal to A minus B upon C. Put your values in brackets and open brackets. What are your answers?
24.4% for negative
5.
53.6. That will be negative 24.5%. Okay, or forward of data, correct?
Yes.
So you must write the answer as 24.39 forward of data. What is the next one?
53.66.
Qualify. 53.66. What? What of datum?
Of datum.
Yeah, aft of datum. You must remember this. Forward of datum or aft of datum. Is everybody with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Anybody any question, do the next one and be careful in reading and understanding. Write down your A, B, C, identify the values and work out. Convert the percentage into distance. Draw it out, plot it out, put your datum, put your MAC, put the position, and convert the percentage of CG into distance, that means from the datum. Anybody got the answer? Okay. How much is the MAC?
58 inches.
So all of you all make a note here. Note down. CG percentage is always taken. CG percentage is always taken from the leading edge. Okay, distance is taken from the leading edge. Now he says here CG limits are 26% to 43% of MAC. So draw your MAC and put two CG symbols. One is 26%, the other is 43%. Of MAC. So draw your two vertical lines, MAC 58 inches. In between that, from the leading edge, put one dot of CG symbol and another dot of CG symbol. One dot is 26%, the other dot is 43%. Draw that. So if the MAC is 58 inches, how much is 26% in inches?
15.08.
Okay. And if the MAC is 58, how much is 43% MAC?
24.94.
And 45?
26.39.
Yeah, so what is the difference? How many inches is it out?
1.45 aft.
Simple. Clear? That is how you calculate. Is everybody following, or Abdul, you can explain in your own way?
Okay, sure, sir.
Anybody got any doubt? Instead of giving ABC in inches, he's giving it in percentage. So you have to convert that into inches.
Jeez. So it's 1.41 inches out of limit.
Has everybody got it?
So the question you're asking for the inches, just correctly we calculate the inches. Okay.
Will you just change that percentage to inches, la?
Okay.
Suppose I say the CG is 50% of 58 inches. What will it be in inches? 50%?
29 inch.
58 inches.
29 inch. 29.
So how much is 26% of 58 inches?
26, 15.08.
Yeah, correct. You all are all intelligent people but are sleeping at the moment. Huh? Okay, do the last one. Read it very carefully. Read it carefully, draw your MSc. Find out the MSc distance. How many meters is it?
3.5 meters.
Very good. That is C.
Okay.
What is A, B, C? We'll find out.
Oh, the CG. The CG is 30% MSc. So the arm of the CG is 1.05 meters?
No. What is the arm of CG?
Oh, arm of the CG.
Ah. Where will the datum be? The CG is taken from the leading edge.
Okay.
But the arm is taken from the? CG is taken from the leading edge of MSc. Arm is taken from the?
Datum.
Where is the datum? So what will the arm be of CG? How much?
17.05.
Very correct. 16 plus 1.0.
Ah, okay.
Ah, now. Yeah, unless you draw it out, it will not be clear. Immediately it will be clear once you draw it out. And you know the definitions. Arm is from the datum. Your CG position is from the forward limit of MSc. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. So that is good. We have done this thing. Now, you have to look at your aviation exam 03104.
Okay.
There are, I think, about 50 odd questions in that. How many are there? 03104s. How many questions are there?
70, sir.
Okay. So there is 03101 CG percent. There are about 16 questions on MSc. There are many other questions with graphs and all. Leave them aside. Tackle only a question that has got the word MSc in it. Out of those 70 odd questions, you will have some on item mass, arm moment, some on MSc. So you can do the item mass, arm moment, there's no problem. You can tackle 4-5 questions on MSc today, 4-5 questions, 6 questions tomorrow, and we will meet day after. Is it clear?
Yes.
So your homework is 2 questions on DOM plus TL plus whatever that thing is.
Okay.
Is equal to zero fuel mass. Then you have to revise your definitions and terminologies. You can practice your 03103. It's a revision for your definitions of CG. And homework for MSc is 4 or 5 questions from 03104. You can do more if you have the time.
Okay.
Any doubts, you all can ring me up today, tomorrow, when you all are doing your MSc questions. We'll sort it out.
Sure, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, when we meet day after, will you give me a new password or what is it?
No, sir. Basically, it will be generated by the system. It's not me who create the password.
Okay. So, you will send me an email?
Sure, sir.
Okay, wait for it. Have a nice time studying. Don't waste time. And look after yourself. I hope you all are gargling and drinking a lot of water.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank
you, sir. Okay, take care. God bless.
Sir, hold on.
Yeah.
Sir, I just want to confirm from our previous lesson on CAP 696.
Yeah.
Okay, so technically, the one that information that you give about the mass and everything, the fuel, everything.
Yeah.
So that one, actually, that one you create the data, is it?
Yeah, I created the data myself.
Okay, so which means technically for every flight, there will be a different flight data. Which
yeah, the different that's what you got to so, calculate.
Oh, okay. So and as then the graph. No? And then the graph after we complete the table, we have the CG location graph, which basically yeah, we will mark the. So what actually the purpose of that graph?
That purpose of the graph is to give you forward and aft limit to see if your okay, CG is working out within the limit or not.
Okay. So because we have to sight on the aft limit and forward limit, so we just want to ensure that our flight in every time shouldn't exceed limit.
Yeah, shouldn't exceed the forward and aft limit.
Oh, okay.
So you have to calculate CG for every flight, every time. You may take off 3 times in a day. You have to have 3 times calculation for CG.
Oh, I see.
And you have to ensure that the luggage loaded and all that thing is within limit.
Okay. Okay, sir.
And then we will do, you know, of changing CG. As a captain, you can remove luggage, you can add luggage. We've done yesterday the first time only okay, shifting of luggage, which I'll do again tomorrow, day after. Okay. And that is how we ensure that as captains that the CG is within limit. You have to calculate within limit.
Okay, sir.
So I'll see you on Wednesday morning.
Yes, sir. Yes, correct.
Yes, sir.
Take care. Do well.
You too. Thank you. You too,
thank
sir.
Thank you, sir. You too, sir.
Bye, bye.
Bye, bye.
Bye, sir.
How many present today?
Today seems like everyone's present, sir.
Okay, good. Send me the report. Thank you.
Definitely, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
you, sir.
Bye.
Bye-bye, sir.
Eh, jap. Korang stay dalam line. Sekejap lagi Captain Guru nak masuk.
Okay.
And nombor 5 ni jawapan dia apa?
17.05. Mana email Guru tu?
Baru masuk.
Siapa yang baru masuk?
Mana ni guru tu?